Gather round, creeps. Gather round, fools. Gather round, spirits, and gather round, ghouls. Listen to me, for I have a story of blackening fright and all things gory. For this is the night when little babies cry and orange mist pours from their eyes. Monster girls and monster men patiently wait for the fun to begin. What do they know that you've never seen? Well, I'll tell you, my friend.
It's rock and roll!
Greetings, kiddies. Welcome to the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus. Please allow me to introduce myself, Mad Brad, your ringmaster for this show. Tonight's show titled, A Love Lost, Love Done. We are showcasing Savannah Nix. The stories, the music behind the legends of rock.
Peter Shannon, I know the plague that cripples you. I've been sent by the Lord to save you and to rid the earth of that plague. I am his holy messenger. Do you recognize me, child?
That's right, kiddies. Welcome to show 628 of the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus. Coming to you live right here on Bulldogs Radio. Standing in my arena, our featured artists this evening, Savannah Nix and Love's Lost Shot.
Slash up. when I sat on it.
What up, people? This is Alex from Fatal Smile from Stockholm, Sweden. This is the freakiest show of them all. This is the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus. And taking the lead, your ringmasters Mad Brad and Kim will welcome you to the freak show.
We'll be right back.
This is Larry Posner from the Rock City Angels, and you've run away with the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus with your certifiable master of ceremonies, Mad Brad. The revolution will not be televised. It will be podcasted. Use once, little babies, and destroy.
Baby, I long to hold and touch you. A dangerous child alone tonight. A kissing evil numbs the pain. It's driving me crazy and my heart turns black. Blood-like eyes, I shed no tears. I'm helplessly praying, but it makes me wonder. The voice in my head that drags your feet.
This is Mike Todd from the group Taipan. You're in the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus with Ringmaster of Rock, Mad Brad. So let's do this with good booze and bad women.
Take me down, down to the river. Lift me high upon the flood. And there will be no turning back. And I must find my love, I must find my love. I must find my love. Well, now meet me in the bottom with the serpents and the vine. And I must shout out loud. Will she still be mine? Will she still be mine? Will she still be mine? I shall not rest upon the highway. I will not tire nor despair. I shall conspire, I will be there. I'll make a deal, I'll dance in hell. I'll sing out loud and loud, yeah. Out in the wild. I should lose my mind. There I must find my love. There I must find my love. There I must find my love. Lead me high, high on the mountain, with the naked and the free. And if I should bear my soul, would you still care for me? 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 I shall not rest upon the highway. I will not die in my despair. Sing out loud and loud and yell.
Sing out loud and yell.
I will open every door. Oh. I'm lost out on the ocean, and I will count the seven seas. So all alone, so high and lonesome. Does she still think of me? Does she still think of me? Does she still think of me?
Story. Greetings once again, kiddies. Welcome to the scariest show on earth, the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, with me, the ringmaster of that show, Mad Brad. Straight into our rock story for this evening's show, kiddies. And that being titled Love's Last Shot, we are showcasing Savannah Nicks. Now, the story of the English glamsters Savannah Nicks started in a very surprising part of the world, namely the northern Italian city of Bergamo. The Italian guitarist Massimo Max Numa had been playing the local club circuit for more than 7 years with the metal band Hallowed. It also resulted in an album with them in 1986, and this album caught the attention of Venom's Abaddon, a.k.a. Tony Bray. He liked what he heard and made it his mission to try and get the guys a record deal. The classic label Neat Records was involved, but the deal to materialize the band would have to relocate to the UK, which the rest of the band was not prepared to do. Newman decided to leave the band and try to put together a new band in London, UK, as his new home base. First, he managed to pick up Italian drummer Fabio Del Rio. Then he was introduced to guitarist Colin Bowles and bass player Mark Goodchild. Together, the first steps of Savannah Nicks were taken in October of 1987. Rehearsal started, and Bowles Goodchild had a lot of songs written already, which were fine-tuned during these sessions, but they still lacked a singer. Almost a year later, after countless sessions trying out different singers, they found Spanish-Swiss-born shouter David Rubio. Savannah Nicks played their first gig at London's legendary Stick of Rock Club in August of 1988.
In November of that year, the first demo, called Ready for the Cruise, was recorded. Shortly after Del Rio left the band, Cal Hullraiser of the magazine Metal Forces, who had heard the demo, compared them to bands like Rat, Dokken, and Striper. Soon, Ramzi Bishara was recruited for the vacant drummer position. In late 1989, the guys entered the studio once again to record a demo, but it was shelved when they changed management and was never used to promote the band. Despite the record deal proposals from a German label and MCA America, nothing materialized due to different demands on the label's part. Lead vocalist David Robbio left in the band in 1990. In came Mark Huckle to fill the vacant frontman position. With Huckle at the microphone, Savannah Nicks entered the studios in May of 1990 to cut the Obscene Obsession demo. Autumn of that same year, I saw them embark on a UK tour with Cheap and Nasty, but the band was faced with great challenges as Bowles and Bissara decided to call it quits in early 91, leaving the band without a large chunk of its core part. Numa put together what was to be Mark IV version of Savannah Nicks, bringing in Carl Chappell on bass, and the drum stool was rotated towards Jules Feilpaar. Savannah Nicks soldiered on. No record deal was in sight, but they got to submit two tracks for a Japanese Metal Muthus compilation, which entitled Love's Last Shot and Free My State of Mind. Released in 1992. The band entered the studio in 91 to record their fourth demo, and these tracks were chosen for the compilation album. By 1992, Max Neumer had set up a mobile recording studio in his living room, and that's where the band recorded their last six tracks. Then came the grunge onslaught, and the club scene disappeared. Savannah Nicks bowed out in early 1993, having given their all. Kiddies, that about wraps up our rock story for this evening. We're going to allow our featured artist, Savannah Nicks, back into the arena to take us out of the rock story a million miles away. But kiddies, I'm not going a million miles away. You stay right there. I'm going to be back straight after this to tell you what's happening on the rest of tonight's program.
Meet my needs. Welcome to the Gypsy of Fortunes. Your coin was very much appreciated, and now I shall grant you your future. It seems my cards of tarot have dealt you a hand of six Joker's cards. This is very rare, and suggests something most hideous is approaching you. You should be visited by a dark circus, a circus of pain and anguish. This traveling mass of evil will leave your lifeless corpse to rot, while entrapping your soul to be displayed at future stops. One who leads this gruesome parade of pain into your life, one sinister beast, one known only as
with your ringmaster, a rock, Mad Brad. Your world will never be the same again.
That's right, kiddies. How can your world ever be the same again? Because it's that time of the week. Crazy time of the week. It's scary time of the week. Time for the scariest show on earth, kiddies. That's right. We are back with a brand new edition, fresh, turned around edition of the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus. And we are here to rock you for another 2.5 hours, at least, kiddies. At least. So before I tell you what's happening on tonight's show, and before we start unpacking the suitcase, let me not be rude, and let me first say thank you to Michael Timvias for the Rock Roadhouse for the handover. Some awesome songs tonight, Michael. Do tune into his show from 6 to 9 every Saturday night right here live on Bulldogs Radio. So thank you, Michael. Over in the United States, we want to say hello to some of our syndicated stations. That includes Triple Trouble Radio from Muncie, Indiana, Digital Revolution Radio in Ogata, Connecticut, NGFY Radio in Seattle, Washington, Hi-Fi Radio in Middle River, Maryland, right here in South Africa, Neisner FM on 97.0 in Neisner, and MCFM in my backyard in Bladenburg Bay, 90.3. Kiddies, and if it's Saturday night where you are sitting right now, we are exclusively live all the way from Ossingen, Luxembourg, live on Bulldogs Radio. One more time for this evening, kiddies. Welcome to the show, boys and girls. That's right. Welcome to the scariest show on earth, kiddies. So what's happening tonight? What have we got for you? Let's put the funk back into dysfunctional tonight. Starting us off with Savannah and Nick. So these guys rock, and unluckily never got a record deal. So the music you're hearing from them tonight was actually never released. Never released, boys and girls. Savannah and Nick starting us off with Love's a Last Shot. In there as well, Giant and Let Our Love Win. Carl Sentence, of course, from Nazareth fame, with his new drop and All Right. Robert Plant, Alison Krauss bringing us out of the first sideshow with High and Lonesome. Savannah Nix, our featured artist, back into the arena with Million Miles Away. Kiddies, we've got another 3 sideshows headed your way with my choice of the latest rock metal drops around the globe. We're going to be highlighting some of those. Lordio in Finnish Rockers are in with their new album, which is out on the 26th of November, Lord Eversity Superfly Trap. Smith and Kotzen are in as a collaboration. Of course, Adrian Smith from Iron Maiden and Richie Kotzen, you know, from the Winery Dogs. Better Days, that's actually an EP, not an album, an EP. That was released on Black Friday. Deep Purple are back with their new album. We've got a new track off the album that's just been dropped on November the 26th. Black Label Society are back, boys and girls, with Doom Crew Incorporated, also released on Black Friday. Sainted Sinners are in with their new album, Taste It, and our Euro for Act 1. The German 80s hard rock veterans are back with Gods of Tomorrow, also released November the 26th. Now, kiddies, that all happening in Act 1 for this evening. We will also be discussing wild rock star rumors that turned out to be true. Do you know any, boys and girls? Let me know in our chat box. Do pop in and say hello to us on bulldogsradio.com. Come and say hi in the chat box. Lots of people to meet there. And we are all friendly, I think. That all happening in Act 1, Act 2, starting us off with our regular Psycho Babble Rap Crazy Countdown, my top 11 hits of all time, with a chosen nightmare word prominent in each song title. Kiddies, so you want to have some fun, this is what's going to happen. I will be releasing tonight's chosen nightmare word in a few seconds' time. You got from now until that part of the show. Let's see how many songs you can get together with that word prominent in each song title. I'll bring you my top 11, and then we'll choose one of the listeners' songs that wasn't in my countdown to play at the end of that. So how's that? Even if you send me one song, send it to me. Come around on Bulldogs Radio or on our WhatsApp group. So last week, to give you an idea, our word was shot, and Ozzy Osbourne, my best solo artist ever, Ozzy Osbourne shot in the dark, taking my number one. So this week, boys and girls, our word is actually not a word, but mostly joined to other words, and our word is teen. Can you think of 11 songs? So you can have 19, teenage, 18, 16. Should I go through the whole? All the numbers. Teen, can you think of 11 songs with the word teen prominent in each song title? That brings us to our grand finale of the evening, our Looney Tune, where we give you a cover version of a great rock classic. Tonight, the song we've chosen is Wicked Game, of course, in Megan Moore and Ray Hanchero in the arena to bring us their rendition of this great song, as you stay around for that. Savannah Nix, take us out, our curtain call, but I'm not going to tell you with what. Are you ready to rock and roll? Let's get some music into this arena. Let's put the funk back into dysfunctional. Coming up, Lordy. Imagine Finnish rockers Lordy performing a classic disco track, kiddies, in the style of ABBA or Kiss or Bee Gees in the late 70s. So while disco music hit its peak, an hilarious and entertaining idea that now becomes reality. The new single, Believe Me, from the album Lord Adversity, Flytrap, which was out yesterday, coming up. Smith and Cotson as well. Smith and Cotson is the name of the musical collaboration between musicians Adrian Smith of Iron Maiden and Richie Cotson of the Winery Dogs. Better Day, the new EP, was out yesterday. Kiddies, we're back after that, after the clown, some Jim Brewer and his take on Metallica.
The thing I miss most about kids, though, is my music. That's what you're gonna miss the most, because I grew up a 80s metal guy. I said, you know, we need some rock music to save children's music. And there's no reason like bands like Metallica and these guys should not be knocking. They all got kids. I think they'd be great. James Hetfield came out, like, get around, yeah! Pretty boys and girls, yeah! Hit a farmer. Had a dog. Yeah! Had a dog, yeah! Bingo was his name, oh yeah! B-I-N-G-O. B-I-N-G-O. Yeah! Ooh, yeah! B-I-N-G-O. Bingo was his name, oh hey! Bingo was his name, hey!
The Sideshow on the Rock and Roll Psycho.
Hey, kiddies, we are on Bulldogs Radio. Into Sideshow 2 of the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus. Standing in my wing, Smith and Cotson. Social Disorder, but let's hand you over to Lordy with a disco take. Believe Me.
Don't even think of you. Sometimes the feeling comes, what if there's something wrong? I know it can't be true, 'cause you're done. We'll be right back.
do nothing right, not even take my life. You're bad at everything. Here's the thing. Look here, I got your gun. I'll show you how it's done. And right between your eyes, say goodbye. So here I'm standing now, full apologies. I have to say I didn't see this coming, so listen to me.
Crazy friends, this is Tulsa Patoy from South Africa's Evolver One. This is the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, and you are in the tent with the ringmaster of rock, the Mad Brad, reaching you from Plettenberg Bay, South Africa. The world's gone crazy, and that means it's time to rock.
Hey! Hey everyone, this is Odd Matthews from Just Ginger. This is the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus with your psychotic ringmaster of rock, Mad Brad. It's time to leave shallow waters and go in deep with some rock and roll. Have a good one. Peace.
And in the arena with a brand new EP, Better Days. Adrian Smith, Richie Kotzen, and Better Days. story of our first second sideshow. Lordy, would believe me, social disorder in there. Raise the glass, followed by Bumblebees. Eye of the Storm, Smith Godson taking us out. And Better Days. Skiddies, we are live on Bulldogs Radio, and we're rocking you all. I'm in Plettenberg Bay. Isn't the internet amazing, boys and girls? I'm in Plettenberg Bay. So what's happening, boys and girls, if you've just joined us? We are looking for 11 songs with the word teen prominent in each song title. As I said earlier, you can have a number, 18, teenager. Oh, you can have teen by itself if you want. I don't know. Let's see. Get your songs to me. You're on Bulldog Radio. Come say hello in the chat room. Speaking about the chat room. So before we start in the chat, let's go to the chat rooms and have a look. Some boys and girls sitting right here in the front row. If you want me to give you a shout out, do pop into one of our social media platforms, the Bulldogs Radio website, WhatsApp, Facebook. Come say, how's it? Let me say hello back to you. Of course, on this side of the ring, I say hello to Michael. Michael, all the way from Sweden. Michael, how are you? I don't know if you can speak Afrikaans, I doubt it. Morris Page in the arena. Good evening. Good evening. And then I see Carol. Carol is in our arena. Over here. We have got Dennis. Dennis, great to see you in our tent again. We miss you sometimes, Dennis. I think Gerald is sitting in the back there. He usually hides at the back and doesn't say anything right until the end of the show. So, Gerald, good evening to you. Claire, good evening, sweet gorgeous Claire. You look lovely tonight. Glad we could have you in the tent with us. Let's say hello to Joy up in Southwest Africa. Joy, good evening to you. Good evening to you. Our house is full, boys and girls. On this side of the tent, let's say hello to Angelique, our kennel keeper. Who can it, Angelique? Angelique, disappointed because she can't go to Paris for, well, maybe not. Go to Paris for season. Angelique, what can I say? Everything is closing down. Everything again because of this new virus. Dollar and Franz up in Luxembourg. Good evening to you guys. Hoe gaan het met jou, Dollar? We miss you guys. We must have a chat again. Ons het so lang laas gepraat. Ek en jy. Franz. And then I see we got Debs in the house. You can catch her right here on Bulldogs Radio. Debs, good evening to you. How are you, sweetheart? Glad you could join the circus. Of course, we've got Jacques Goodwood in the house. Henry and Jacques. How's it there in Goodwood? Is it raining a lot there, I wonder? I wonder. Of course, there was one of my regular listeners. There was back in the house. Good evening to you. And let's not forget Larry. Good evening, Larry. LW, as I call him. Larry, great to have you in the show. So if I've left anyone else, if anyone wants a shout out, do give me a call. Call me. Let's see. So I'll draw a star rumors that we want to discuss tonight that turned out to be true. What a topic. So although some have a bit of importance, nuance to them. So one of the longest lasting and most widespread preconceptions about rock stars is that they live wild, extravagant lives, often getting up to weird stuff that we mortals couldn't or daren't even dream of doing. So of course this line of thought proved to be true to an extent, often enough. But the fact that people also tend to fantasize about their favorite musicians' lives has made it hard to discern fact from fiction in most cases. As a result, some pretty wacky stories kept on circulating for decades, despite not containing even an ounce of truth, while others kept on being dismissed as false, despite actually being true. So tonight, let's take a look at some of the wildest rumors about famous musicians that actually turned out to be true, although in some cases, they may not have gone down the way we thought. So, kiddies, let's begin with this one. We all love them, don't we, boys and girls? Yes, Van Halen. Now, Van Halen demanded that all Brown and M&Ms should be removed from the backstage. Tales of rock stars having specific instructions for how their backstage should be set are frequent enough, and these usually feature weird and often hardly believable demands that people tend to write off as superstition or personal whim. The story of Van Halen's stark opposition to Brown and M&Ms was long thought to be one such example, especially since the band threatened to leave the venue should their backstage M&M bowl contain any brown candy. But however, kiddies, however, in the case of Van Halen, this particular mandate had practical purpose to it. As David Lee Roth explained in a 2012 interview, the presence of Brown M&M's backstage meant the gig organizer didn't go through the checklist that Van Halen provided prior to their shows, and that the band's unique and highly demanding technical requirements may not have been met as well. Makes sense, doesn't it, kiddies? Put brown M&Ms in your hotel room order. Boys and girls, kiddies of all ages, we're going to run off. We're going to see what's happening inside show 3 of tonight's show. You keep working on those lists. 11 songs with the word teen coming up. Deep Purple also coming up in the next set with their new album Turning to Crime, which was out yesterday. Black Label Society with their new drop, Doom Crew Incorporated, will be available on Black Friday. Kiddies, we're going to run off. We're going to let some Jim Brew in the arena for the clown section. We'll be back with that right after this.
Ozzy would be great if London Bridge is falling down, falling down, falling down. London Bridge is falling down, my fair lady.
The Sideshow on the Rock and Roll.
Oh yeah, kiddies, we are in Bulldogs Radio Land. Setting my wings, Black Label Society. Bill Jeffers White, let's hand you over to Deep Purple with their new dropping. Rocking it and the money.
Baby, that ain't all. I want to kiss her, but she's way too tall. A young man with a gun.
a hold of me too. I got the rockin' pneumonia and a boogie woogie flu. I wanna squeeze it, but I'm way too low. I would be running, but my beat's too slow. A young man grinning got a hold of me too. I got the rockin' pneumonia and a boogie woogie flu.
Hi there, this is Tully McCulley from McCulley Workshop, and you're listening to Mad Brad and Kim on the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, reaching you from Plettenberg Bay, South Africa, rocking you all over the world. The Rock and Roll Psycho Circus with Mad Brad and Kim.
She's fucking crazy, like you wouldn't believe. Done all that I can do. No good, she don't listen to me. She's a fire burning down my back. She's popping pills and smoking weed. She's doing lines and drinking on my jack. It's a nightmare, I can't wake up. She's burning down, down. She's burning out. She's burning down, down. She's burning out. She's burning down, down. She's burning out. I try to stop her, but she's getting bad. I talk and talk to her. It don't matter, she gets mad. Cause she don't care. She don't even try. She cares about is being drunk and getting high, getting higher, but she's getting tired. She's burning down, down. She's burning out, out. Burning down, burning out.
She's burning down, down. She's burning out.
Hey, this is Ron Keel, the Metal Cowboy. You're listening to the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus with Mad Brad. Crank it up!
Cool it up.
Arena to take us out of Sideshow 3 with their brand new drop, Black Label Society, in the spots, and set you free. Of our third sideshow, Deep Purple, Rocking Ammonia and Boogie Woogie Blue. Bill Jeffers white in there. She's Burning Out, followed by Hailstorm, Back from the Dead. Black Label Society taking us out with a brand new drop and set you free. Putting the funk back into dysfunctional right here on Bulldogs Radio. Saturday nights, isn't it great, kiddies? And scary. Let's not forget scary. So, boys and girls, if you've just joined us, we're looking for 11 songs. Can you think of any? With the word teen prominent in each song title, you start getting those lists together. We're coming up with that almost later on. Almost later on. So, kiddies, what we have been discussing are rock star rumors that turned out to be true. We spoke about Van Halen with the brown M&Ms. And for my next one... my man, Ozzy. So, Ozzy didn't get his legendary nickname by just being the most iconic singer of the most influential heavy band in history. No, the Prince of Darkness's sheer chaotic nature, coupled with a whole slew of wild and utterly unexpected incidents throughout his career, have lent the nickname an aura of genuine, bedazzled spookiness. Of all these, the bat-biting incident proved to be the most notorious one. Back in 1982, a particularly intense Ozzy Osbourne show in Iowa gave birth to a fast-spreading rumor about the famous musician's ecstatically biting off a bat's head during the gig. At first, a lot of people dismissed the rumor, claiming that the bat in question was a rubber toy. Eventually, the bat turned out to be real, although Ozzy himself thought it to be a rubber prop. However, that wouldn't even have been the first time that Ozzy decapitated an animal with his mouth, as just a year prior, the iconic musician had purposely bitten off the head of a dove during a board meeting with CBS Records. Originally, the dove, there were two of them in fact, were meant to be released after the meeting in a celebratory manner and were brought inside by Ozzy's wife and manager at the time, Sharon Osbourne. Howdy, Ozzy, kiddie. Only Ozzy. So, biting off the bat. But it made him very famous about that. The last one. Of course, Aerosmith's Dude Looks Like a Lady is about Vince Neil. Aerosmith's catchy 87 tune has been the cause of many a giggle, as well as quite a few raised eyebrows throughout the years. But it gets all the more stupidly hilarious once you realize that it is, in fact, about the Motley Crue singer Vince Neil. According to the songwriter Desmond Childs, Aerosmith Toxic Twins were out on a bender one night when Steven Tyler got smitten by what he thought was a glamorous blonde woman. Turns out the woman in question was actually Vince Neil of Motley Crue, as Nikki Sixx later corroborated in his autobiography. Members of both bands had a laugh and a beer, and Vince Neil barely escaped being taken to bed by Steven Tyler. Kiddies, we're going to run off. We're going to allow the clowns into the arena. We're getting back with a last sideshow for this evening. And hidden in that, boys and girls, brand new drops coming out. Sainted Sinners, November the 26th, the melodic hard rock band Sainted Sinners released their new studio album, Tasted. Victory on the German 80s hard rock veterans, Victory, are back. They released their new album, Gods of Tomorrow, November the 26th, after 10 years, boys and girls. We're back with that after Jim Brewer.
And I mean, AC/DC would be the ultimate. They'd be the ultimate. I would give AC/DC row, row, row your boat, because they'd be amazing at it. They'd be amazing at it. Just come out, Lou Angus, come out. And then Brian Johnson, another great front man coming out. You got to row, row, row your boat. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream.
The Sideshow on the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus.
Oh yeah, kiddies, we're back with the last sideshow for tonight, sending him a wings Victory, our featured artist Savannah Nix coming up. Let's hand you over to Sainted Sinners. And off the album Taste It, here they are with One Today. Featured artist, kiddies. Let's see Savannah Nix. And she's so intense.
See. Concini, and you're getting rocked hard with the almighty Mad Brad and Kim on the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, the show that is rocking the world. Now let's rock.
We got honky tonk bass blasting off your face as the drums are filling up the room. We got black charred lungs, venom licking tongues, rejuvenating deadly fumes. And I'll sing so low to the depths of rock and roll beyond the last sip of a pint. And when the sun goes down, my angels will burn me alive. Dust is clogging up our veins, and we're selling our cells for booze and plastic whales, splitting pennies with a rusty blade. And I'll sink so low to the depths of rock and roll beyond the last sip of a pint. And when the sun goes down, my angels will burn me alive. And I'll sink so low to the point of no control, I think I lost the last bolt in my mind.
To take us out of Cytophone Act 1, we have Victory in the Arena. Yeah, they are back after 10 years. And of the album Gods of Tomorrow, yeah, they are with Cut to the Bone.
Never
started off our last side show, Sainted Sinners, and one today, Savannah Nixon, and she's so intense. Johnny No Cash taking us there with Burned Alive, a victory, taking us out and Cut to the Bone. Into the ring I come, kiddies. The scariest show on earth. Right, you're live on Bulldogs Radio. And yeah, we're looking for 11 songs coming up right after this. 11 songs with my top 11 with the word teen. Now, come on, kiddies. I'm getting some good lists in. Got some songs from Dola. She says she doesn't want to Google. She wants to think of them. So she's thinking very hard. Go, Dola. Google, I dare you. And then, of course, Angelique sending me her 11 songs. Very good, very good, very good. I'm loving the list. Do send me your songs. We've got some other songs coming from some other people. So do keep sending them. Boys and girls, we are discussing tonight Rockstar rumors that turned out to be true. We spoke about Van Halen with the brown M's. How many M's were there? So Ozzy Osbourne, of course, he bit off a bat's head, and a dove's head, Aerosmith's rumor about a dude, looks like a lady song, being about Vince Neil. And for the last one, the last one, I'm going to eat it from about there. So for the last one I've chosen, the Beach Boys bought the recorded a Charles Manson song. And kiddies, this is true. Charles Manson's notorious failed attempts at becoming a rock musician and constant Beatles fanboying certainly did no favors to rock's reputation in the late 60s and early 70s. And when the word got out that the Beach Boys had actually recorded one of his songs, even more eyebrows started being raised. The story began just a year prior to the tragic Tate murders, when a couple of girls that the Beach Boys drummer Dennis Wilson brought home in 68 turned out to be members of the Manson family. That very next day, Charles Manson himself came to Wilson's house and started courting the musician by hooking him up with various women from the family. Apparently, Manson had wanted the drummer to get him into the music scene, and Wilson eventually bought a song called Cease to Exist off the notorious cult leader. However, Wilson would go on to tinker with the song despite Manson's explicit wishes for the opposite. and eventually released it as Never Learn Not to Love as a part of the Beach Boys 69 album 2020 without crediting Manson. So allegedly the turns of events infuriated Manson, who then went on to issue death threats to Wilson, only to have his ass handed to him by the famous musician in return. Kiddies, we're going to run off after that. How are those lists coming together? 11 songs with the word teen coming up after the clowns jump through in the arena and his take of nursery rhymes and Iron Maiden.
Metal, it's the same thing. It's just that we're older. 80s metal is the Wiggles, but it's for adults. That's all it is. That's all. It's great. Here, I'll prove it to you. Who's in Iron Maiden? Anyone in Iron Maiden? Okay. Fine. Now, yes, you're in Iron Maiden. You love the music. Yeah. I get it. Well, let's be honest. When you go see Iron Maiden live, what are you really hoping shows up at that concert?
Eddie!
For those of you going, what are they talking about? Eddie is a mascot. It's just a big skeleton. What is it? I don't know. But you'll stand there for an hour going, hey, I like this song. And then all of a sudden... And then a grown adult, like, oh man, it's Eddie!
Eddie just came out. You're missing it, bro. You're missing it, bro. Let me get an Eddie shirt, two Eddie shirts.
It's the Wiggles. Ozzy Osbourne, he's a Wiggle. I love him. Wouldn't Ozzy's voice be great on a GPS? It'd be entertaining but useless. Calculating route.
Jim Brewer there, maybe some more Jim Brewer coming up. Kiddies, time to put those pins on. Hold on, whatever you care, very tight. Your nightmare wizard's here to take you to dreamland.
Tell you about a dream that I have every night.
Bulldogs Radio, you're listening to the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, Psycho Babble Rap Crazy Countdown, my top 11 hits of all time, with the word teen prominent in each song title. Kiddies, let's not waste any more time. Let's run over and see what never made it into this week's top 10. My bubbling under.
The Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, Psycho Babble Rap. Great.
So bubbling under, I have got Jim Brewer in the arena. Can you believe it, kiddies? And here he is, the raising teenage girl.
Teenage girls. Don't get arrested, pregnant and
had a nice run. Look at me now, all cool somehow. I got time for fun.
Everybody's saying that it's gonna be fine, but they're not dealing with kids like mine. And teenage girls. Wow.
You're on your what? Whoa, yeah, no, I can't help you.
Where you live, and guess what? I don't trust you, kid.
Everybody's saying that it's gonna be fine, but they're not living in a house like mine. So come a little bit closer now, and welcome to my family. Can't you see me standing here with my head spinning round? But come on, there ain't nothing in this world like raising teenage girls. Teenage girls.
Securing a place in my top 10. Our featured artist in the arena, Savannah Nix. At 19.
Yeah.
Position 9 going to...
Do you feel it? This whole room, this... Everything is in color, and I can feel the air. I can see it. I can see all the molecules. I'm part of it. Oh, it's just like you're released, or you're free.
None other than Rob Zombie in the arena and Teenage Nosferatu Pussy.
I am tomorrow. I am.
coming in at number 8. Some glam rock for you kiddies. We have Sweet in the Arena. And Teenage Rampage.
All over the land, the kids are finally starting to get the upper hand. They're out in the streets, they turn on the heat, and soon they could be completely in command. Imagine the sensation of a teenage occupation, the 30 little early.
And at 14, they'll be burning, and there's something in the air, which we all must be aware. Get yourself a constitution. Come join the revolution now. And recognize your age. It's a teenage rampage. Turn another page on the teenage rampage now. So recognize your age. It's a teenage rampage. Turn another page on the teenage rampage now.
They couldn't be on, they're doing it wrong. If they're gonna do it, it won't be long. Heard they got the word that truly belongs, and now they're coming on strong. Imagine the formation of teenage legislation. At 13 they're a fooling,
but at 16 they're ruling, and there's something in the air which we all will be aware. But they don't care, no, 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 no. So
come join the revolution, get yourself a constitution. Come join the revolution now.
Your age, it's a teenage rampage. Turn another page on the teenage rampage now. So recognize your age, it's a teenage rampage. Turn another page on the teenage rampage now.
Position 7 this evening. We have my man Alice Cooper in the arena. And I'm 18.
I'm in the middle without any plans.
halfway mark. We have Rainbow coming up and 16th Century Green Sleeve.
Memories will burn you. Memories. sweet 16. Oh, I see it's clear, baby, that you are all through.
So my number four going to classic rock band Autograph, 19 and Nonstop.
Yeah.
Not happy with it, kiddies. My favorite's Kiss in the arena. And Christine, 16. Hello to Ingrid and Jonas there. How's it, guys? We into number two, yeah. And none other than Nirvana taking silver this evening. And Smells Like Teen Spirit, kiddies.
She's so
this is Bulldogs Radio. You're listening to the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus Psycho Battle Rap Crazy Countdown, my top 11 hits of all time with the word team prominent in each song title. Kiddies, it's time to compare those lists. Bubbling under this week, Jim Brewer raising teenage girls. In at number 10, Savannah Nix at 19. Rob Zombie coming in at 9 and Teenage Pussy Sweet. In at number 8, a Teenage Rampage. Followed at number 7 by Alice Cooper, I'm 18. Number 6, 16th Century Greensleeves by Rainbow Billy Idol. Take him on number 5. With a Sweet 16 Autograph. In at number 4, 19 and Nonstop, followed by Kiss at number 3 with Christine 16. My number 2 position going to the great Nirvana and Smells Like Teen Spirit. Kiddies, it's time for number 1. Taking this week's number 1, kiddies. Oh yeah, you got that by now. The great Stevie Nicks, and I'm giving you a very rare live version. In the arena with Edge of 17. Take it
just
away.
Like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. Just like the white winged dove sings a song, sounds like she's singing. And the days go by like a strand in the wind, in the web that is my own. I begin again. I said to my friend, baby, you know nothing else matters here. Does not change, does not change, does it? So
How do you beat Stevie Nicks and that? Off the original, off the album Belladonna, which was her debut studio album, released in 1981. And of course, yeah, it went to number one on the US Billboard in the September. Awesome, then, Stevie Nicks. Kiddies, we got a bit of time left. I say we get that Wheel of Death into the arena. We give that a spin. We put your soul on the line. We spin the wheel and we see who's lucky listener wins the song for this evening. We gotta do some gambling with the devil, kiddies. Say how we do this every week if you haven't been here before. And every week it's like a clockwork day, it's the same. Oh dear, does it look good? Of course it has, full of rain. All the way in France, can you believe it? And the song she sent me, of course we've got to have it in our show. Some Steely Dan and Hey 19. Hey, you enjoy your winnings, lonely.
Thank you.
So how do those lists compare, kiddies?
Psycho babble, all psycho babble. I don't care, it's all psycho babble, rock to me.
Boys and girls, time for our grand finale, this week's Looney Tune. Our Looney Tune, the part of the show where we give you a cover version of a great rock classic. A great classic indeed tonight. Song chosen, Wicked Game by Chris Isaak. Now, this is a tale of obsessive love, and Chris Isaak spoke about that, the late night event, which inspired the song. And he said, this one I wrote really late at night, and it was written in a short time, because I remember that a girl had called me and said, I want to come over and talk to you. And I said, okay, you're coming over. And as soon as I hung up, I thought, oh my God, I know she's going to be trouble. She's always been trouble. She's a wildcat. And here I am. I'm going to get killed, but I'm doing this. And he wrote Wicked Game while waiting for her. And she wasn't happy when she got there, because he was more excited about the song than her. So kiddies, tonight we've got Megan Moore and Naranjo in the arena, and they're going to give us a rendition of Wicked Game. But I'm going to leave it up to you to decide which version you prefer.
Make me dream of you.
Now I
all, folks.
What did you say?
Nothing.
That is almost all, kiddies. It is almost done. It's time for you. Take the takedown, turn the show around, ready for next week. Good boys and girls, you can find us on Facebook, the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus, Bulldogs Radio. Do like it. You can also find the following groups and radio stations. You go visit them, like their pages as well. Triple Trouble Radio, Digital Revolution Radio, NGFY Radio, Hi-Fi Radio, MCFM in the Plattenburg Bay Area, Nice FM in the Nice Area, Bulldogs Radio exclusively live every Saturday night all the way from Luxembourg. And do go find our podcasts at madbrad.podbean.com. 628 shows to download for free, so do go pop around. Now, kiddies, this is what I get to tell you, that you, yes, you, have been a radical freak, psychotic, wicked, awesome, the most awesomest company ever. Thank you so much. We're going to hand you over to our featured artist, Savannah Nix and Cherry Bomb. Just experience the concept of the Rock and Roll Psycho Circus. Show 628, Love's a Last Shot, showcasing Savannah Nix with me, Mad Brad. You join me again next week, where we get together the stars to light a path through the sky, so we can unmask the spirit of rock. Until next we meet, this ass is down.
Bad breath, the rock, the rock, the rock.